Hi, and welcome to the third episode of the Excel to Power BI series. I'm Dave from Automation and Answers. If you missed the first two episodes on pivot tables and Power Pivot, you can watch them by clicking the link in the top right corner of the screen or in the video description. Today we're going to talk about Power Query, a tool that automates the process of cleaning, combining, and transforming the data you use in your analysis. So let's take a look. As per usual, the link to the example files is in the video description. Every year at our company Dave Sports Warehouse, we get new sales data. And every year, we make the following tedious manual adjustments to get it ready for our analysis. Delete the top three rows and invoice ID column. Remove a particular customer. Split the delivery driver column into two columns. Change this delivery date string into a proper date because the year, month, and day are squished together. And finally, go to our sales folder and copy paste the data from each file into one table so we can build our pivot table. With Power Query, we can automate this using these three steps: get data, combine and transform data, and load data, and we'll do that into a pivot table. All right, let's begin with the setup. If you're using Excel 2016 or later, or Microsoft 365 like I am, you'll find Power Query under the Data tab. If you're using Excel 2010 or 2013, you'll need to install the Power Query add-in, link is in the description, and once installed, Power Query will show up as a separate tab on your ribbon. If you're using Excel 2007 or earlier, Power Query is not available. And if you're using Power BI, Power Query will be located under the Home tab. All right, the housekeeping is done. So let's begin by getting our data. Here, I have a blank Excel workbook. To get data into Power Query, start by going to the Data tab, click on Get Data, and here we can see different options. We'll select from File, and here we can choose from Excel, CSV, and even a PDF file. We'll choose from folder, navigate to the sales export folder containing the three Excel files we saw earlier, and click open. We see three files as expected, and at the bottom, we'll click combine. If our data required no further changes, we could select combine and load, or combine and load two. However, in our case, we have changes to make, so we'll choose Combine and Transform Data. The first thing we need to do is choose a sample file. This is the file we'll use to tell Power Query which changes to make. By default, it's the first file. We could change it if we want, but the first file is fine. We'll select the sheet we want to import, the sales sheet. And now we see a preview. It's important to note that each sales file has a sheet with the same name and column headers. All right, everything looks good. Click OK. This takes us into the Power Query editor. On the left side, we have our queries. A query is simply a request for data, in our case, sales data. To keep things simple and clear, we'll minimize this, which will leave us with two queries. Then, we'll rename this one to Part 1 Sample File and the other to Part 2 Combined Files. This is because we'll make our changes in two parts. First, we'll tell Power Query the changes we want to apply before the files are combined. This is where we'll use our sample file. And second, the changes we want to apply after the files are combined. We'll start with Part 1. So click on it and look over to the right side. You'll see the query settings, and under that you'll see the query name and applied steps. Think of the applied steps as an Excel macro. These are the steps that Power Query will perform every time we import data. As you can see, Power Query has already applied a few steps to get our data to this point. It started with the source, which is the sales sheet. Then it displayed the data and promoted the first row to the headers. As you notice, When we click on any step, we see what the query looks like after that particular step. If we look in the formula bar, we see the M code for that particular step. M is the language used in Power Query, and advanced users can update this code manually if they want. All right, let's start automating our process. When we look at the headers it promoted, we can see they're not correct. The ones we want are in row 3. So we'll click the X to remove that step. To get the correct headers, we'll start by removing the extra rows at the top by going to the Home tab, selecting Remove Rows, Remove Top Rows, and in the Number of Rows, we'll enter 3. Click OK, and now the rows disappear, and a new step is added to the applied steps. And to finish it off, we'll promote the first row to our headers by clicking Use First Row as Headers. And now, we have our correct headers. The next change is to remove the Invoice ID column because we don't need it for our analysis. So we'll right-click, select Remove, and now it's gone. Next, every year our colleague Larry asks us to make an equipment donation to his nephew's sports league. And he thinks it's hilarious to make an invoice. We let him do it, but obviously we need to remove this from our analysis. Click on the down arrow in the customer header and uncheck Larry's nephew from the list. Click OK, and now it's filtered out. Moving on, we want to split the delivery driver column into two distinct columns, one for the delivery driver and another for the delivery date, because this 8-digit string is the year, month, and day all bunched together. Right-click on the delivery driver column, select Split Column, select By Delimiter, and choose Custom. And type 2 dashes because that's what splits the driver and the date. You can also choose where you want to split, but we'll leave it at each occurrence, and click OK. And now we have 2 columns. However, the delivery dates are still funky. To convert them to proper dates, click on the Add Column tab, and select Column from Examples. We'll scroll to the right to see our delivery date strings, and in column 1, we'll start typing the date format we want, which is day, month, year for the corresponding delivery date string. The first date string is the 2nd of January, 2021, and press enter. And we can see it highlighted in green, the delivery date column, because it recognized we were trying to convert that string into a proper date. Amazing! Click OK, and now we have a proper date column. We no longer need the old column, so we'll right-click and select Remove. Finally, we'll rename this column to Delivery Driver and the other to Delivery Date. If you've enjoyed this video so far, please consider subscribing and clicking the like button. A sincere thank you. Now it's time to go to the Part 2 query. And we have a nasty error message. It says it can't find the column Dave's Sports Warehouse. And that's because, if you remember, we changed our headers in the previous query, so it can't find the original headers. And as you can see in the M code, it's referencing all of the old column names. To fix this, we'll go to the Applied Steps and click on the X next to Change Type. And now we're good. As mentioned, in this query, the files are combined. And because of that, a new column called source.name is automatically added. It provides the name of the file where that particular row comes from. If we click on the down arrow in the column header and click on Load More, we can see there are 3 files. That said, we don't need this column, so we'll right-click and select Remove. The last change we need to make is to the data types. Data types tell Power Query the kind of data stored in that column and conforms the data to that data type. This is different than data formatting, which only affects how the data is displayed, but doesn't change the underlying data. The ABC123 icon signifies the any data type. And as we can see, it's been applied to every single column. If we wanted, we could click on the icon and select a different data type, but there's a much easier way to do this. Click anywhere inside the table and press Ctrl A to select all. Navigate to the Transform tab and click on Detect Data Type. And as we can see, it detected a date for the two date columns and text for the customer's products and delivery driver. However, for the sales amount, it detected a whole number, but really we want decimals, so we'll change it to that. A pop-up will appear and we'll select Replace Current to replace the whole number data type it originally set in the Changed Type step. Perfect! Our data is ready to load for our pivot table. To load our data, we'll go to the Home tab, click on the Close and Load down arrow, and select Close and Load 2. On this screen, you decide where to load your data. If you want to load it to a table like we had in our first episode, select Table. If you want to add it to a data model like we saw in our second episode, select Only Create Connection and check Add this to the data model. And next time you go into your data model in Power Pivot, you'll see it there in your data model. In our case, we want this to load directly into a pivot table without creating a table. So we'll click on Pivot Table Report. And when choosing this option, the data is stored in the pivot table cache. We'll leave New Worksheet selected and click OK. And now we can build our pivot table. We'll go to the Field List pane, put delivery driver in the rows quadrant and delivery date in the columns quadrant. And we'll remove everything except for years. And lastly, we'll put invoice amount in the values quadrant. Perfect. Now, if you've watched the first two episodes of this series, you'll know that we don't believe in having ugly pivot tables around here. So with the magic of video, I'll apply the exact same beautification changes we applied in our first episode. If you're interested in learning about them, the link to the first episode is in the video description. Now it's time to test out our Power Query import process. We'll go to our sales folder and add our 2024 data. Then we'll go back to our pivot table, right click, and refresh. And there it is, 2024. If we ever want to go back into the Power Query editor, all we need to do is click on the Queries and Connections icon on the right side of the screen. Right-click on any query, select Edit, and there you are. And once you're done your changes, simply click Close and Load. And that's it for our tutorial. Quick recap. We got the data from our sales folder using GetData. We combined and transformed our data using the Power Query Editor. And lastly, we loaded our data into a pivot table and easily imported new data. In our next tutorial, we'll cover Power BI, a tool that opens a whole new world of possibilities in data analysis. Hope to see you there, and best of luck on your automation journey.